Hello everyone, my name is Ashwani Jaiswal and I am a Chartered Accountant. In today's session, we will be discussing about the composition scheme under the Goods and Service Tax. In order to go through the composition scheme option, which is available under the Goods and Service Tax, we have to first understand why it was required. There are various compliances which a business has to go through under Goods and Service Tax. The motive of the government was that a small taxpayer don't need to go through all those compliances and be burdened with the compliances. Okay, hence this composition scheme was introduced by the government, where there is less return filing, less compliances, and a fixed rate of interest on which a small businessman has to pay a tax. Okay, right. First of all, we have to understand who can avail the composition scheme. Point number one: if suppose someone is manufacturing or selling a good, the threshold limit for him to opt composition scheme is 1.5 crores, okay? And if he is providing service, the threshold limit for him is 50 lakh rupees only, okay? What's happening is, a normal taxpayer who is not a small taxpayer or neither he has opted for a composition scheme has to file a GST return every month, okay? There are two returns at present which he have to file every month, okay? In composition scheme, rather than filing return monthly, what is there is he have to file a return quarterly, okay? So he has to only file 4 returns in the entire year, whereas the other taxpayers who is not opted for composition scheme has to file minimum 24 returns which he has to do monthly, okay? So 24 returns in total annually, right? There are also certain restrictions for the people, for the taxpayers who can't opt for composition scheme. Suppose he is a manufacturer of ice cream, pan masala or a tobacco product, he can't opt for composition scheme, okay? Number two, if he is a service provider or a seller or a manufacturer who sells his product or provides services from one state to another state, right? Interstate supplies. Suppose if I am a businessman located in Uttar Pradesh and I am providing services in Bihar or selling products in Bihar, then I can't opt for composition scheme, okay? So there is a restriction on that. Point number three is, if a casual taxable person, by casual taxable person I mean that if I am located in Uttar Pradesh and there is a fair in Mumbai and I go to Mumbai to sell my product or to list my product or to advertise my product, then I am a casual taxable person in Mumbai, right? So I have to get compulsory myself registered in Mumbai and I can't also opt for the composition scheme, okay? Point number four talks about the businesses which provide services or which supply goods through an e-commerce operator, okay? By e-commerce operator, I mean to say that e-commerce aggregators like Amazon and Flipkart. I'm a seller, I list my products on Amazon and Flipkart and through which I sell the products to the consumer. So for me, I can't opt for composition scheme, okay? There are certain conditions which I have to comply with in order to be under the composition scheme, okay? First of all, I can't take input tax credit, okay? The government has provided me a scheme under which I have to pay goods, I have to pay GST on a very less rate, okay? But the condition is you can't avail input tax credit on that, okay? Point number two, I can't sell any exempt code. There are many exemptions which are available in GST. If I am dealing in that and I am also dealing in the taxable good, so I can't keep availing the exemption under composition scheme, okay? There are certain conditions which one taxpayer has to keep in mind in order to be under the availing the composition scheme. Point number one, he can't take input tax credit, okay? He can't charge GST from the customer, okay? He has to pay GST from his own margin itself, okay? He can't give any tax invoices, okay? He has to provide bill of supply. Also, where his business is located, he has to specifically mention that he is a composition scheme dealer, okay? He is registered under GST under composition scheme. It has to be specifically mentioned, okay? These are the conditions which one have to keep in mind in order to avail the composition scheme. Thank you.